Currently, the GNPC, through a partnership with Swiss Africa Oil Company, a Ghanaian company registered in the Netherlands, and Gosco, a consortium of oil companies, have commenced offshore petroleum exploration, whilst onshore exploration is soon to also commence in the Keta Basin, amidst high potential to hit petroleum in commercial quantities in the near future. This is expected to have some impact on 35 communities within the Keta Basin. The Petroleum Commission, which is the industry regulator, believes it is learning from experiences from the Jubilee field to minimize impact.
We've learned our lessons from there. That's why we keep coming here. All we are telling them is data is going to be acquired within this period. We are not asking you to stop fishing. We are not taking your livelihood away from you. What we are telling you is some of these activities that we do has safety implications. It has actually started. Both Gosco and then Swiss Africa are on schedule to acquire seismic and then drill wells within the first 3 years. So from now till 2018, 2019, we should see some wells being drilled. The Petroleum Commission is working together with the EPA to ensure that, if data is even going to be acquired onshore with the dynamite, we are working around the clock, we are working very hard to ensure that at least the livelihoods of the people will not be adversely affected, and then the environment, after the seismic activity is done, will not have any adverse, effect on the environment.
Despite the ongoing exploration and the potential to discover oil in the Keta Basin with its challenges, residents in major communities including Keta and Anglaga have little information but high expectations in case of discovery.
Personally, I haven't heard anything about it, that there is an exploration going on in the Volta region. But I know there is exploration going on in other regions. But if it will happen or there will be an exploration in the Volta region, personally, I'll be glad because, you know, it will create more jobs, the region will develop, we will have more expertise in the region to develop the region.
I'm Philomena Atinyo from Anglaga in the Volta region of Ghana. I heard that there are going to be oil business in Anglaga. I think that will benefit our youth to get business to do and those who don't have any work to do. And I think that is going to benefit me too. Because when people come from far away, I think they'll have some clothes for me to sew and that will make me get my money or that will make me help my business grow very fast. I think that's good.
The expectations aren't different from these ones captured in the Western region following the Jubilee and the 10 offshore projects.
My expectation is that the local content will be expanded so that we get more of our youths getting employment.
We hope that there's going to be greater transparency with this thing, more social investments in a direction or a vision that we all buy into. That's the most important thing. And so this project fills all of us with hope.
We will catch all this. Eh? And how are we going to get fish? This one too will destroy the nest.
Concerns such as these arising from the Jubilee field and the 10 projects on the western coast of Ghana is what the Institute of Financial and Economic Journalists, IFEJ, is seeking to prevent from being repeated in the Keta Basin in the event of a discovery. In line with this, IFEJ, with support from ILA Latin America, is promoting local business involvement and managing expectations through sensitization on radio.
I'm just gonna talk here, then do the and
community interactions as well as public debates. One of such well-participated public debates addressed by officials of GNPC, Petroleum Commission and GOXPA offered residents the opportunity to seek clarification on the exploration, local content opportunities and the environment at Keta.
I think it is the time for us, with the citizens and the chiefs, to sit down and see and use this opportunity to visit other regions where this company are operating. What are the effects and what are the benefits they are getting? We come back and then we sit with the people and discuss.
It's clear that we don't have oil yet, but one of the representatives Center said that we should get ourselves prepared. So now my question is that, are they going to employ our people during the exploration stage or period
Ghana is producing oil in Western region. And we know that when that oil is being produced, what we are taking is not enough. So a lot of people have been complaining about it. And I want to know, since you are the expert, what are you going to do so that when oil is found in Keta Basin over here, the percentage we are going to take will be more than what we are taking currently? Thank you.
If somebody has gone to borrow money and is coming, there is something we call the risk. You look at what the person is bringing on board, how much he has contributed. Ghana, we don't add one peso. The current oil that we are producing, that we are fighting for equity, we didn't contribute one peso. It is by virtue that we signed good agreement. So the interest we have, like the property rate, the interest, because we are partners, we carry our interest forward. So our percentages grew upwards. Now, Ghana has learned a lesson about the oil agreement that we have. So we have a petroleum commission that oversees everything that we do, that people will benefit. The SWACO one we are going to do now, the reason why we are here, GNPC is a partner. Our percentage is bigger. So these are the things to tell you that everything we come here to say is to share information with you, for you to know that we are growing.
I'm very happy about this morning's function, because it is a forum that explains what Swiss Africa is going to do in our Keta municipality. Gone were the days when you only see people walking within this littoral without any explanation from many quarters. But now that we are in a communication world, and then information, it is now at our doorstep. So we will know that this is what is going to happen. And then this is the role of the chiefs, the community leaders within the community. So whatever our subject will be saying, we may be at the better position to explain it to them, that, oh, these people are doing this and that. Initially, some people are saying that it will not be a blessing to the community, but rather a curse. And then what they are saying is that when you take Nigeria, for example, areas that they have done onshore exploration, in fact, it affects their lifestyle. You see, economic activities come to a halt. Trees and other things, die. So that's what they are saying. But they are also saying that we are now using modern technology in doing things. Those things will not affect. Now that we are on the verge of exploring, let's see what they will come up, especially the EPA. You see, we are only waiting for the EPA to come and tell us something, that this is what will happen.
The purpose of the activity itself was to bring people to understand the issues. And so I think that we have achieved that. We have whipped up their enthusiasm. We have whipped up their interest in the oil and gas industry. If Ghana should strike oil in the Keta Basin, these are the same people who would need to get jobs to do, who would need to help in making the environment conducive enough for the operators to operate here. We don't want a situation where they don't understand what is going to happen, and at the end of it, we'll have another Niger Delta here. So this activity must be continued. It shouldn't be a one-off activity. Because gradually, every now and again, new questions will arise. And when the new questions arise, we need to have them to understand the issues. And that is what IFEJ intends to do.
This took IFEJ members, officials of GNPC, Petroleum Commission, and the Ghana Oil and Gas Service Providers Association, GASPA, to seven communities within the Keta Basin, including Angraga, Keta, and Bomigo, an island community where their message was widely received.
IFEJ is doing very well by synthesizing the natives and the people on the whole project, for them to know a little bit more about the oil sector. So it's a very good thing, but we have to learn from other countries that are far advanced when it comes to this oil sector. Do we have the expert knowledge when it comes to the citizens? Do the citizens have that knowledge to help in the production of this oil? If it is no, then at least we have a little more to do by educating them. That's the importance of learning this oil, learning about the oil sector, so that when the time comes to for the exploration, they can help in producing. But the thing is, if we didn't do this, it will come. Time will come when the citizens will rise against the producers.
Ghana Oil and Gas Service Providers Association is of the view that the time for preparation by local SMEs seeking to play a role in the potential Keta Basin petroleum industry is now.
And basically, SMEs in the region should get ready, seek knowledge and information from Petroleum Commission, GNPC, and of course from us, Ghana Oil and Gas Service Providers Association, as to how to get ready. There are certain certifications they need to go through and acquire and get ready for the industry. It will not come easily, but there is an avenue. Enterprise Development Center, which is being situated in Takoradi, is there, which will play a key role in building the capacity of SMEs. There are other stakeholders who are also doing the same, like the Ghana supply chain, etc. There will be the requirement for drivers, security personnel, caterers, chambermaids, suppliers of various items, yada, yada, yada. So they need to seek for information. They need to really start now.
So, what is next for IFEJ on its advocacy for local participation and exploitation management?
IFEJ, you know, it's a study group and it's an advocacy institution. So we are taking this part of it, is the advocacy part of it. And we have been training young journalists in the oil and gas sector, the extractive sector, for the past 3-4 years. And we think that we also have to take a lead role in some of the things that we do, so that at the end, those journalists who have trained in this area, in fact, we also come along here and train some of the journalists who operate within the locality, so that when the time comes, they will know how to carry themselves through. They will know how to ask the questions and they know how to report on the issues pertaining to the environment, pertaining to the operations of the oil industry. These things involve a lot of money. And for IFEJ, we will have to be looking for the money. And if we find the money, we'll continue it. We'll move to the next level.